already did some shopping, but you know, I might do a little bit more. Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Shayee and this is The Daily Shayee. On this channel, I share fashion hauls, styling videos, beauty tips, the whole nine. So if you are interested in any of that, then please feel free to continue watching this video and or subscribe to the channel. In today's video, I am going to be taking you guys through five neutral spring outfits. I do plan on sharing five colorful spring outfits in the next coming week, so please stay tuned for that. So as a disclaimer, neutral for me personally is like cream, tan, white, kind of like that deep army green, black, jean, denim. Those are all neutrals in my eyes because I think that neutrals are pieces that can go with other pieces. And so all those colors, in my opinion, can go with so many different colors. Really quick, what I'm wearing right now, I'm wearing Jenny Bird hoops. These are the hoops that I legit wear all the time. They're like my everyday hoop. I am obsessed with these. And then my necklaces are from a black owned jewelry company called Lelia May. I also wear these necklaces every day. I'm always layering them because they're just such nice pieces. And then this particular one, it's like a woman's body. I don't know if you can really tell, but it's like a woman's body, and it's just very simple, very sexy. And then this black blazer is thrifted. It's actually part of one of the outfits I'm going to show in today's video. So if you'd like to see some five spring neutral outfits, then just continue watching. All right, for the first outfit, we have this sort of plain on white on white. I feel like the white on white trend is just really nice, crisp, and clean. Personally, I'm not the biggest fan of just stark white, especially when it comes to bottoms. For some reason, I feel like it can sort of age me personally a bit. And so whenever I go for more like, you know, white bottoms, I lean towards more like ecru colors, ecru cream. So these pants are actually from Zara and I got them a little while ago, but I'll try to link some similar options down below. And I love them because they're sort of like a almost professional looking pant. I wear these pants just on a regular basis because I think that they're cute. I think that they're nicely tailored and they fit really nicely around my thighs, which is one thing that sometimes Zara pants don't really do that. I have thicker thighs. I am a size 8-10, depending on the brand, depending on the style, depending on the fit. So I also paired it with this shoulder pad tee that I got from ASOS. These muscle pad tees have been on trend for a while now. I'll definitely link some options below. I just decided to pair it with my Dolce Vita sandals. I really like these sandals. They're very simple and they're sort of like this tortoiseshell color. It's a nice like brown just to kind of offset the whole outfit. Next, we have this bandana top plus baggy jeans combo. And so I actually styled this in an Instagram video. I'm doing this 30-day outfit challenge over on Instagram. So if you would like to see me style a different outfit for the next 30 days up until the end of the month, then please go ahead and follow me there because I am sharing an outfit every single day. But I love this outfit because I said in that video that it's given me very much like Y2K. And I say that because the bandana top is definitely Y2K. It's everywhere. It's just regular old satin, so I feel like it's soft against the body. I'm dressing it down with this blazer, this black blazer that I mentioned in the beginning of this video, along with these kind of like baggy jeans that I got from Zara. They have two rips in the knees, and I actually got this last year, so I'll try to find a similar pair and I'll link it below. And I just absolutely love these jeans. They fit so nicely. I believe I got these in a size 10 for that more like baggy, kind of very loose around the waist look, and very happy with my decision and that sizing. Next, we have this tan vest and these wide leg army green culottes. They are denim and I featured them in a my favorite jeans video because these jeans fit me so nicely. Like, the fit is out of this world. And I also styled them in that 30-day outfit challenge. I did style it in there. But I really like it with this tan vest situation because this vest can be buttoned up, it can be tied up with the belt that it comes with, or you can just leave it open. So for this outfit, I decided to go ahead and tie it up because I kind of wanted to sort of just cinch my waist a little bit. Since we have the flare action going on at the bottom of these pants, I figured why not cinch my waist just to give my body a little bit more dimension, a little bit more some going on. But you can pair it up with heels, you can dress it down. I decided to pair it up with heels because that's usually my preferred way, but I am expecting a couple of different shoes in the mail. So I think that I would also pair these with like a nice pair of brown sandals, like just flat sandals that you can just slip on and slip off. I really like the balance of colors between the tan and the army green, kind of like some of my favorite color combos is this, just this tan and this green. I did get this vest from ASOS a little while ago. I got it beginning of quarantine. So I will link some similar options below because they do still sell like kind of like these sort of linen vest. And again, because it is linen is definitely a spring summer staple. I have my eyes on a couple of other pieces. I already did some shopping, but you know,
I might do a little bit more.
I would highly recommend, if you're wanting to sort of add a little bit more upscale look to your wardrobe without necessarily breaking the bank, you can do so by just adding a couple of linen pieces, and that will definitely do the job for you. Then next up, we have this crop white button up and the sort of like baggy, but you know, cinched waist jeans that I also got from Zara. So I wanted to include another jean look because, again, in my opinion, denim is very much a neutral. This cropped white button up, I actually styled it in another video a few weeks ago. These can be styled so many different ways, this particular top. I feel like this is a really nice casual look. In a perfect world, I would have paired these with some shoes that are literally not here yet. There are some tennis shoes. I don't have the shoes yet. That's okay. So I paired it with another pair of white kind of like running shoes that I have. Again, this is not my preferred shoe that I would wear with this. The shoe that I'm thinking about has more of a platform. These do not really have a platform, but I decided to just pair it in a way just so you kind of see the vibe, because these jeans are very much like baggy. It's not necessarily figure hugging. It's just there, which I think sometimes you need some pants like that. Pants that are just there that you can just throw on and go out the door. And so these are definitely those pants for me. This cropped white button down is one that I absolutely love and I've been wearing and I will be continuing to wear. Bought it from Aritzia and it is sold out. It's sold out. And I bought it in store. They didn't even have that many sizes available. And then online, I was looking at it online before, and also the sizes were going so quick and I think it officially sold out. But do not fret, because I found basically an exact dupe of this. I'm gonna link it below. It's half the price. This Aritzia top was about $50, which in Aritzia prices, that's actually pretty cheap, you know, because Aritzia is a little pricey. But this one is 25 smuckaroos, which I think is very cheap, especially for this style. I personally just always love dressing it up with jeans because it just looks chef's kiss. And then last but not least, we have this pretty much all black fit. And so we have this pinstripe black pant with the split hem, and then this sort of sheer button down with this black crop top underneath. Black is definitely a neutral for me, but in order for me to wear black in the spring, it needs to be flowy enough where I feel comfortable and I don't feel like I am burning up. And have told myself that I will wear black in the spring, maybe not in the summer, but I will wear black in the spring because why not? Just wanted to show how you can make black work for spring. So like I said, this shirt is very much sheer. It is see-through, so you can wear either like a black bralette. I decided to just wear it like a black crop top underneath this so I don't be nipples to the wind. It is still very much a lightweight top. I'll link some similar options below, but I love this because it has like some satin-ish detail on the cuff and also on the collar, which I do like because I feel like it kind of looks up the shirt overall. Now these pants I talked about in my wearable spring trends, because pinstripes are in right now. I'm just saying, they're everywhere. But this particular pair is from Urban Outfitters and I am obsessed with these pants. It makes my booty look delicious. It makes it look amazing. I mean, am I not supposed to make my butt look good? Yeah, exactly. I do really like the pinstripe because I do think that it sort of elongates my legs. Granted, my legs are pretty much already kind of long, but you know, who's to say another 2 to 3 inches of length on my legs? Why not? Pair this with like just a regular black heeled sandal. For this video, I wanted to keep it all neutral. You can always add a pop of color. Muted green, the muted blues would look really good with black. I think that it works really well. So yeah, those are my 5 spring neutral outfits. I hope that you enjoyed this video. I honestly really enjoyed putting all these looks together because now I got looks to wear. Like I mentioned, I've already worn that bandana top look, so now all these other 4 will be worn somewhere, someplace, when I got places to go. But I appreciate y'all so much for watching today's video. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I will catch y'all in my next one. Until next time, bye.